Welcome to our Grade 6 Performing Arts Showcase, When We Were Wild. This afternoon, we are excited to share with you our learning in drama classes with Ms. Bernstein and Ms. Yekachuk, and our learning in music classes with Mr. Bortz and Mr. Vanderreep.
This year in our drama classes, we have explored and learned techniques in voice, body, movement, and creativity. Today, we are excited to put our units of learning together to present three acts that each class has written collaboratively.
Our performance is inspired by Marie Sendak's classic 1963 children's book, Where the Wild Things Are. In drama class, we read his story and then began to research and explore monsters in performances.
We looked at different monster archetypes, like monsters who are misunderstood, like Phantom from Phantom of the Opera, monsters as heroes, such as the Incredible Hulk, monsters who are psychologically hideous, like Pennywise from It, monsters who are physically hideous, like Gollum from Lord of the Rings, and we can't forget the friendly monsters, like Cookie Monster and Elmo.
After researching about our monsters, we then created our own monster. We decided on the physical features, voice, movements, and actions of our own monster. Then we chose what archetype they represented, what their background is, and gave them a name. You will meet many different monsters in today's performance. I'm Inna Burn. I'm a psychologically and a physically hideous monster who has fire and lava powers.
I'm Tu Ying. I'm based on a Chinese yin yang. One side of me is evil and the other side is good. I'm a misunderstood monster.
My name is Mary Lynn, and I'm psychologically hideous on the inside, but I look really nice on the outside.
In the process of creating our first act, Six RJ discussed important elements that we should include as we wrote the beginning of the story, such as setting a scene and introducing the characters. We are excited to share our collaborative script writing with you. We have written many fun Mulgrave aspects, language, and songs that represent us as grade 6 students in 2018. We hope you enjoy When We Were Wild.
The night Max wore his wolf suit and made mischief of one kind and another.
Oh, who's a good boy? Oh, Spot, go fetch!
Max, your ball just broke my window. I've told you 1,000 times about staying out of my yard.
It's not my ball.
You're standing right in the tulips. You're destroying the bulbs. I'm going to speak to your mother about this. Tell your mother what you've done and that you need to pay for my window.
No.
Excuse me.
Woof, 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 woof.
Get out of here, you beast scram. My children,
oh, what a lovely day. Isn't retirement a dream? So wonderful.
I love being able to have a picnic in the middle of the day on a weekday.
Did you see the next book on our book club list?
Yeah, it's The Rule of Three. My niece, who's a grade 6 student, read that for the NY Reads program at that fancy school she goes to.
Oh, I heard they're getting a new expansion, a whole new West Wing. So exciting.
Go get some of those treats for us.
Get out of here, you slobbery dog.
Max, not again. Get your dog out of here and leave us alone.
No!
Now there's slobber all over my Whole Foods scones.
You're so annoying, Max. Do you know what a brat is?
No!
Obviously, this is no place for a picnic.
Oh, it's time for yoga class anyways. I need some mindful breathing.
Mom, Max is ruining my perfect selfie.
Max, leave your sister alone. Now go set the table. Honey? Go take the garbage out before we eat dinner.
Honey!
Go take the garbage out.
Sure, honey. Max, go take the garbage out.
No!
Max, get down from the table!
No!
Max, get down from there right now!
I'm taking you to your room.
Thanks for dinner, Mom. My friends are here.
Hey, girls, let's go to my room. It's crazy around here.
Sure.
OMG, I love
it
your
smells
new top.
OMG, guys, my Instagram post got more than 1,000 likes.
Hold up, did you hear that Jason broke up with Jessica?
You two would make a totes cute couple.
Yeah, I totally ship you guys. OMG, your couple name, Jason plus Emily, Gemily.
OMG, shut up.
Hey guys, we should totally go shopping on Saturday.
Yeah, we totally
OMG,
should.
You guys. The other day I was at Nordstrom and I think I was at Zac Efron. See?
OMG, you're so lucky.
Let's take a selfie.
Can I play with you guys?
We're not playing, Max. We're talking about serious stuff. Go find some little kids your own age to play with.
No, I'm not a little kid.
Ugh, get out of here.
Ugh, your brother is so annoying.
Yeah, I'm glad that I don't have any brothers.
It's so pathetic. Like, doesn't he have any of his own friends?
I heard that. Do you know why Kylie has all of these posters of Justin Bieber?
No, stop!
Because she's in love with him.
Oh my God.
What about Zac Efron?
Did you know that she cheated on her homework and copied the answers off the answer key and wore the same socks for a whole week?
Ew. Max, get out of here and mind your own business.
No.
You wouldn't want me telling Mom about the window you broke, would you?
You wouldn't.
Oh, but I would.
It is so annoying. Let's get out of here, girls.
Yeah, let's go to the mall.
Why wait till Saturday?
Shopping always calms me down.
I call King.
I call Queen.
I call Jack.
Ha! Max isn't done.
No, I called Jack.
Too bad.
No.
Hey, Jay, what's on?
Pin screen steals. Service. Wait, no, that was totally a fool.
No, obviously, that made it.
Jay, just get out.
Fine.
Okay, pins, steals, and cheap serves. Service.
Haha.
Wait, no, I was not ready.
Yes, you were.
No.
There's nobody in line. Why should it matter?
It matters because I said so.
Max, just get out.
No.
Yes.
No.
Max, get out.
So annoying.
I know, right?
Thankfully, he's not in our class.
All right, students, make sure you've submitted your homework on Google Classroom. Once you've done that, get into your groups and start working on your script.
Wait, what homework?
The assessment that we've been working on for the last week. Come here and talk to me about this.
Haha, you're in trouble again.
The dog probably ate his homework.
Agreed. Yeah,
totally. Mm.
Well, it wasn't posted on Google Classroom, so I didn't get it.
Yes, you did, Max. Everybody got it, and they completed it.
My iPad was glitching, so I wrote it on a piece of paper, and my dog spot ate it.
I called it.
So did you do it or not?
I don't remember.
Let's talk about this later. Go and join your group.
Max, stop sending me silly emojis. You're being really distracting.
No.
Max, we've got to finish our script this class. Could you please just focus?
No.
Mr. RJ, Max is listening. He won't help us write a script. He won't compromise not being a good group member.
Max, come here right now. Max, what you're doing is very irresponsible. I'm disappointed in you. Do you think those were smart choices?
Yeah.
Max, this is the third time this week I've had to talk to you about this issue. I think it's time we had a chat with Miss Mitchell about your behavior.
Busted! Haha, you're going to the principal's office again.
At least there's one to distract us now.
Why can't you behave yourself, Max?
Everyone else out for recess. No lingering in the hallways.
King,
you need to get outside for some fresh air. Excuse me, Miss Mitchell, do you have a minute? I'd like you to have a chat with Max about his inappropriate behavior in class.
Sure, have a seat, Max.
Thanks, I'll be in the staff room if you need me.
Can you tell me what's been going on, Max? This isn't the first time I've had to see you this week. It sounds like you haven't been alert and engaged in class, and you haven't been getting along with others. Is this true?
No.
All right, well...
Roar!
Max, this is not secure and calm behavior! Max, get down from there! I'm going to have to call your parents. We need to have a little chat about your behavior these days. We need to find a way for you to solve your problems peacefully and be kind and compassionate to others.
Never!
I think it's time to run a marathon. Slow and steady wins the race!
Mom, Max is kicking me!
Please stop it, Max.
Keep your hands and feet to yourself. Keep control of your body for once. Please.
On guard!
For goodness sake!
Is this the kind of behavior you have at school? You know, I got a call from the principal's office today. It sounds like you're totally out of control.
We're gonna have a little chat, you and I.
Max is always like this. He's terrible at school.
You're always like this.
Maximus!
Stop it!
Maximus!
You wild thing!
I'll eat you up!
Maximus Cardon, calm down!
Go to your room, mister.
Says who?
Says me.
His mother called him Wild Thing. And Max said, I'll eat you up.
So he was sent to bed without eating anything.
That very night in Max's room, a forest grew and grew, until his ceilings hung with vines, and the walls became the world all around.
And an ocean tumbled by with a private boat for Max. And he sailed off through night and day.
And in and out of weeks, and almost over a year, to where the wild things are.
We hope you enjoyed 6 RJ's Act 1 of When We Were Wild. Now we'd like to share our learning from our music classes. Throughout this year, we have explored and practiced many new skills, techniques, and concepts. We started the year learning rhythm skills on djembes, which are African drums.
Grade 6 has been an exciting year in music. We moved on from the wind instruments of grade 5 and started learning how to play the ukulele, a 4-stringed string instrument. We welcome the challenge of learning how to move our fingers very quickly across the fretboard and learning different strumming patterns.
This year, we've also had the opportunity to consolidate our theory knowledge of harmony and melody and apply this to our ukulele performances. Throughout our units, we have explored composition and have reflected on the world around us, connecting non-musical themes to musical concepts.
For our musical performances this afternoon, in small groups, each class will perform original compositions of melody and chords, which reflect their group design monster.
Please welcome the Wild One 6R to the stage.
For our first motif, we chose to use the chords C and G. So the first motif is considered the most happiest, so we chose to use the repetition of high notes, like C and G.
For our second motif, we chose to use the same chords, but with the rest in between to make sure that the B note would not clash with the other chords.
We ensured that the chords matched our melody so that it would sound clear and it matches our feelings.
For our third motif, we used the chord A minor to show that our character was thinking of becoming a monster.
The notes we used were lower, dark, and had a horror-style feel to it. The notes A-sharp clashed with the A minor key, bringing a less happy feeling.
In the third motif, the character dismissed the uncertain feeling he or she was feeling before and went back to feeling happy and lively. Here we used the G chord to match our notes.
We feel this sums up our piece. We hope you enjoy our motifs.
Good evening. Our names are Kennedy, Ella, Nika, Emma, Alex, Mateo, and Angelina.
Emma, Ella, and I are playing the melody.
While Nika, Alex, Angelina, and I are doing the chords.
For our first motif, we have a very happy mood to show the personality of our character before it transitions into a monster.
We use major chords to show that they are happy, and high notes to show that they are feeling upbeat.
In our second and third motifs, we use major and minor chords which clash together,
so that it gives an uneasy and unsettled sound.
In this written piece, our monster will be entering its final stage. It is the complete monster.
We use melodic chords and motifs to represent the story of our monster in the short piece.
In the first section, it is as if the monster is following someone and attempts to catch them.
In the second section, the monster is chasing the person. This is why the music is faster and higher pitched.
And in the third, the monster is sulking into the shadows with its prey, which is why the music seems like it's slowing down.
The notes we chose for our chords are A minor and C minor. They are unsettling, which makes the piece feel dangerous and frightening.
We have all worked very hard on this piece, and we hope that you all find it as wonderfully frightening as we do. Now we will be playing all three motifs together. Thank you.
In the process of creating our second act, 6Y discussed important elements to include as we wrote the middle of our story, such as conflict amongst the monsters, suspense, and comedy. We hope that you enjoy Act 2 of When We Were Wild.
And he sailed off through night and day, and in and out of weeks, and almost over a year to where the wild things are. Max stepped off the boat and onto the land of monsters. He gazed around at the landscape in front of him and took his first steps on this new land.
Whoa, this place looks so cool. Hello? Is anybody here? Anyone around?
Ah! Need a hand?
I'm here to destroy you!
Looks like we found dinner.
Lucky for you, we're still full from lunch.
We'll give you a 3-second head start. Ready?
Pass me the marshmallow, Sleepy. I have a desperate need.
Right away, Ellie. Do you want a lollipop to go with it to make it a little more sweet?
Yes, please.
Hello?
Huh? What? What is that?
Who are you? You look funny.
Hey, everyone, come check this out.
Meow. Who is he? I wonder if he's friendly. Meow.
Why is he wearing that weird costume? He's not answering us. Does he speak a different language?
I am Max. I'm a king from a faraway land. And who are you?
I am the majestic Thorn.
My name is Hong. I can teleport.
I am the wise Nabi. And apparently, I'm the only one here with common sense. You don't look like a king.
My name is Spot, and I can shapeshift.
What? Spot? My dog's name is Spot.
Ruff. Did you say you were a king? We happen to be looking for a king.
Yes, I am Max. I rule the faraway land with magic and special powers.
Can you give me powers?
Wait a second, stop talking to him.
Yeah, he's not a friend or a king.
We've found him first and we get to eat him.
I should have destroyed him when I had the chance.
We all have powers too, you're not that special.
We don't need you here.
Hey, that's not fair, we get to stay in this too.
I'm not sure about this.
And when he came to the place where the wild things are, they roared their terrible roars and gnashed their terrible teeth and rolled their terrible eyes and showed their terrible claws.
Max said, be still, and tame them with a magic trick.
Be still! Look at my thumb. Levitation. Bang!
All hail wise!
Yes! Thank you! Louder! Thank you!
That's ridiculous. Anyone can do that. Look.
Okay. I've got another one. You, come here.
Who, me?
Yes, you. You had a nose, but now you don't have a nose.
Help, my nose is gone, it really is gone. You are God.
Yes,
thank you. Louder, louder.
Seriously, are you guys kidding? Tuying, feel your face.
It's scientifically impossible to steal one's nose.
Is your nose still there?
Yes.
Because he didn't actually steal it, it's just a trick.
Hold on. What about this?
He is magical!
All hail
wildness! Thank you!
All hail
wildness!
All hail wildness!
Victory at last!
Thank you.
OMG! I just searched him up on my Insta and he has 30 followers! That's more than me! He's famous! I'm so excited!
Fine, but we'll keep our eyes on him.
And I'll keep my eyes in his mind.
30 followers! I guess that sounds legit, but I still want to destroy you.
but one wrong move and...
I still don't think you're the wisest.
I still don't think you're the greatest.
He stared into all their yellow eyes without blinking once, and they were frightened.
There are many reasons why I should be your king. Firstly...
This one's for you, Miss Reed.
I am the wisest, and I am the greatest. For example, I have tamed wild beasts. I've created tunnels through snowy landscapes, and I built castles made out of sand.
This sounds vaguely familiar.
Sounds like Max is cooking up something good.
Also, I've conquered the skies. For example, I have flown from land to land inside a tin can.
I've conquered the skies. A bit of a hyperbole there, Max.
And finally, I imagined my own boat, and I sailed across the seas to arrive here.
Meow. That was a very convincing cookbook paragraph. Congratulations. You've earned yourself an 8. Meow.
This is taking too long. I'm getting hangry.
Let's confer.
He just got here. We don't know anything about him. I don't trust him.
Yeah, he's an unidentified species.
Who cares where he's from and what he looks like? We need a new king, and Max has all the qualities we're looking for.
This is taking too long. Let's settle this the old-fashioned way.
Rock, paper, scissors!
No playing dirty. Best out of 3 in rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
May the best fairy win.
Who will
and
win?
May the odds be ever in your favor.
Who will win? Hashtag Team Thorn or hashtag Team Primrose?
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot! Whoa!
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot!
Yes!
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot!
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot! No! You're
the winner!
I was going easy on you anyway.
Don't be so salty!
After much deliberation, we proudly appoint you as our new king of our society.
Congratulations, your crowning ceremony will proceed in a few minutes.
And they called him the most wild thing of all and made him king of all wild things.
We're not worthy! We're not worthy! All hail the wildness! All hail the wildness! All hail the wildness!
I know we've had our relationship troubles in the past, but I'm proud of you, kid.
Meow, let's get your grandpa to your ceremony.
Now presenting our new king, king of all wild things, king of all monsters, King Max!
All hail King Max!
King Max, what will be your first act as king?
Everybody, floss. And now, may the wild rumpus begin!
Miss Worldwide, let's celebrate! Yeah! Yeah!
Wow, those monsters sure know how to party. Looks like Max has won them over as king. There are certainly lots of different monster archetypes represented on stage, from sweet, cute, friendly monsters to some scary, psychologically hideous monsters.
Max was very brave, meeting all those different monsters, and he effectively convinced them to make him king with that war-prepared cookbook paragraph. Now please welcome the real wild ones, 6RJ, to the stage to perform their musical motifs.
Composed our music to put an image of our huge, suspicious, and misunderstood monster in your mind.
He has blue fur, is very round, has big green eyes, and a large black mouth that covers half of his face.
Our motif portrays suspicion by including the first 5 frets on the C string, which all have a mysterious sound to it. This motif uses the notes in the C chromatic scale. As the notes go up the scale, we get a sneaky and mysterious theme for our monster.
For our chords, we use minor chords to show suspicion. We also use major chords to show the bright side of the monster, which is when he's talking or dancing.
In our performance, we play in different sections. At the beginning, we start with the motif and we get quieter as we play. In the middle, half of our group does the chords and the rest do the melody. To finish off, we all play the chords.
This represents our monster because in the beginning, he still remains suspicious as he sneaks around. In the middle, he starts to get crazy and turns to his happy side. And at the end, he calms down and starts to get mysterious again.
Inspiration for our monster from Snorlax, a Pokemon who is approximately 2 times the size of a hippopotamus. He's a mosaic blue outer body and a whitish beige stomach.
In our composition, we wanted to highlight his lumbering demeanor and tendency to become enraged when people steal his food.
The structure of the song is about our monster waking up groggy and realizes that people have stolen his food and starts pursuing them. At the height of the chase, he then slows down and takes a rest. He then finds other food to snack on.
First, you will hear our harmonic element introduced through an exciting additive minor chord progression. This is meant to portray our monster when it is pursuing a person who has stolen their food. Each strum represents a footstep as the monster builds up his speed.
The melody has been designed to contrast the chords, depicting our monster taking a break from the chase. We did this by using wide melodic intervals to make it sound like he was taking big steps, 1 foot at a time, to walk around instead of running.
Our piece ends with just the melody, played with a great grand ritornando. This slowing down represents our monster just lounging around and enjoying his food.
Thank you.
Our monster that we created is a spider that has black fur, a scorpion tail, the pink bow tie, has 10 eyes, is the size of a human, and has hands and feet at the end of each leg.
The name of our monster is Alien, meaning different in Latin, which we feel connects with our monster. This is because our monster is meant to be strange and shouldn't be able to fit in with others.
In our piece, Ava, Sandy, and I are playing a melody which is dark sounding. It sounds dark because we chose the lowest range possible on the ukulele and mainly in chromatic intervals.
For our harmonic element, Gabe is playing dark minor chords and I am playing light major chords at the same time. This reflects our monster's strangeness because the effect of combining major and minor chords is an awkward dissonant sound.
The form of our composition starts with just the chords to set the mood before adding in the melody. The combined effect of the dark melody and awkward harmony depicts the appearance and different nature of our monster alien.
Created a ukulele piece inspired by our clumsy and awkward monster named Benunu.
He tries to be normal, but often he finds it easier to just be weird. We have transferred his personality into the melody and chords that we have created.
Benunu is a very awkward and clumsy monster, but he is also very happy all the time, which is represented in our bouncy melody rhythm, which is in triplets.
Our melody is very simple and fast, which reflects his energy. For our chords, we use E minor to portray his awkwardness with the sad and lonely sounds.
Also, we use some major chords to show his excitement towards the sun and bananas, his two favorite things.
The form of our composition introduces the chords and melody separately, before combining them all for the finale, showing all the characteristics of Benunu.
Now that we've seen the darker or more strange side of all these monsters, we actually had the students recomposed all of the themes to be on the lighter side. So we created a happier chord progression and we tried to think of more of a monster dance party rather than them hanging out by themselves. So you'll hear all the groups enter in one by one and they have recomposed what they just played for you to put it all together in a lighter sense. Thank you.
As you can see from Six Wise Act 2, we have created many weird and wonderful monsters. Some cute, some not so cute. We created our math and visual arts class where we drew inspiration from our creations in performing arts class. We first created an artist's intention, then we drew up designs for our masks. We got gooey and sticky working with paper mache and then added details with different designs.
In the process of creating the final act, 6R discussed important elements that we should include as we wrote the ending to our story, such as a reunion, a discovery, important last lines of the play that will make the audience think or reflect on their own lives and experiences.
We hope you enjoy Act 3 of When We Were Wild.
We've been around the world, sing song. Work hard, play harder all day long. All the continents get jealous over me. You can see me 3D overseas. If you know me, then you know where to find me. Off in the Bahamas with a band one behind me. Now live it up, live it up, live it up. Baby, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. And we go.
Now stop! Now stop! Now stop! Go to bed.
Max said.
But why?
We just started the Congo line.
You're being loud.
What's wrong?
The king just told us we're too loud.
Party pooper.
You're too loud. You're too wild. You're out of control.
We're not loud.
But I just had a Red Bull. I just got my wings. I have so much energy.
You're too loud, and for that, I must punish you. Now go to bed without supper.
But I haven't chewed my garlic bread yet.
Some king you are.
You will regret this.
I'm warning you, Max. I want a party, and if you don't let me, I will whack you with a stick.
I said, now go to bed now.
And Max sent the wild things off to bed without their supper.
I miss home. Ow. I miss my bed. Miss my sister. I even miss Justin Bieber.
And Max, the king of all wild things, was lonely and wanted to be where someone loved her best of all.
I wish I could go home.
And then from far away, all around from across the world, she smelled good things to eat.
That smells like bagels. Bagels. I miss my mom's fresh bagels right out of the bread maker and cream cheese. So yummy. I miss my mom.
Sounds like she's homesick.
What's a bagel?
I was just warming up to her. What if she leaves us?
Did you hear me? What's a bagel?
Oh no, what do we do?
You think she might leave us?
Even with my overpowering fluffiness. Do you see how cute I am? How could she walk away from this?
I'm not kidding. What's a bagel?
It's not about the bagels.
She can't leave. She's the wildest king we ever had. We gotta do something.
Excuse me, do you know that every night we have a massive game of Fortnite?
Yeah, and have you seen our giant Red Bull can? It's the biggest Red Bull can in the entire world!
Oh, please don't go. I'll show you my fossil collection.
I can make a mean fried chicken.
We can learn about bagels together.
Have you tried my homemade organic non-GMO gluten-free vegan grass-fed whole wheat bread? It's not a bagel, but it's delicious.
We could give you the luxury treatment at our all-day spa. The avocado face mask.
The cucumbers in her eyes.
The cedar manicure.
I can teach you my magic trick. The coin's here. The coin's there. The coin's here. I lost my coin. I'm sorry.
I've got one. 52 pickup. We have fun picking that up. Guess you have to stay.
Have you seen how beautiful we are? I mean, not those monsters, but I mean, just look at us. Stay and gaze at our beautiful faces all day long.
Hold up. Are you calling us ugly?
Hey, yep. Everyone, calm down. See, Max, we can problem solve effectively on our own.
All of this sounds great, but maybe one of you should be the king?
What?
I think it's cool here, and all of you are super nice. Well, most of you. But I should be back home. My mom, dad, Kylie, and Spot. I came here to escape my problems at home. But I need to face the music. I need to go back home and start making some smarter choices. Mom, Dad, and Kylie are probably really worried.
So she gave up being king of where the wild things are.
I have to leave.
Seriously? I built a castle for you. I even chipped my nails for you. Look at this. Look at this.
If you leave now, I will have one more person to hunt.
You spoilt girl. I gave you rocks. I gave you sticks. I gave you ashes. And you give us this? I knew it. I should have sucked at your blood when I had the chance. I didn't even think of that.
Who have I become?
But I shared my garlic bread with you. I thought we were friends.
But the wild things cried.
Oh, please don't go. We'll eat you up. We love you so.
Oh, please don't go. We'll eat you up. We love you so.
And Max said no.
No, I can't stay. I need my family, and my family needs me.
The wild things roared their terrible roars and gnashed their terrible teeth and rolled their terrible eyes and showed their terrible claws.
You'll be fine here. We're all so lovely. Well, most of you. You don't need me. You have each other to rely on and care for.
But Max stepped into his private boat.
I'm sorry. I will remember you always.
Well, that was fun while it lasted.
Maybe Max is right. She needs to be with her family.
What about us?
Well, we're a family. We're one big family.
You're my family? You're wild. We're too loud. We're too wild. We're out of control.
In the best way possible.
Families are like fudge. Mostly sweet, with lots of nuts.
Home is wherever my bunch of crazies are.
Maybe we don't need a king. We can just rely on each other.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Every family has a story, and I guess this one was ours.
Today was the day we became a family and lived happily ever after. Everybody, I have discovered an unlimited resource of bagels. To celebrate our new family, let's celebrate with a feast. Woo.
Yeah! Yeah!
Max waved goodbye and sailed through a year, in and out of weeks, and through a day.
And into the night of her very own room, where she found her supper waiting for her.
And it was still hot.
Home is where the bagel is.
What's a bagel?
We hope you enjoyed our version of Where the Wild Things Are. We had a lot of fun creating the script and sharing it with you today. And last but not least, here's 6Y performing their music motifs.
In music class, we have created a list of 3 different motifs that portray an emotion of sadness. A motif is a repeated pattern that portrays an emotion and helps people recognize a song or a tune.
The first motif's major themes are loneliness and depression. Since the monster's misunderstood, we used all minor chords to portray a sad feeling. Along with this, we also create a strumming pattern to clarify the chords.
This motif is the most sad. We used low chords and we slowed it down to make it sound more depressing.
We start off with the chord D minor, which fits the emotion well. Then we switch to the chord A minor, which sounds even more sad. Finally, we alternate back to the chord D minor to lead into the third motif.
The third motif is the frustrated motif. This is where the monster becomes psychologically messed up, per se. We use the chords A, C, and E to make it progressively more frustrated as the chords in the melody crash. A and the melody work well together. C, not so much. E, it doesn't sound very good, but that's to show that he is frustrated and just mad. I hope you enjoy our motifs.
Our monster is depressed and frustrated and transitioning to happy and heroic.
Our first motif consists of chords and a melody that clash against each other. This allows our motif to sound neither sad or happy, but angry, frustrated, and annoyed.
The chords played in the second section clash and do not fit together. This represents a more upbeat sound, giving a thought of hope and happiness.
The chords then change to show the extra frustration in the monster's thinking when reflecting on its past story. These emotions are shown by playing different chords, notes, and motifs.
We leave a gap between the chords, adding suspense to the audience, making them more intrigued and engaged. This also brings a feeling of shock and surprise to what's going to happen next. This allows the monster to gain confidence in himself.
Then the first part repeats, which represent that he is failing and not succeeding at what he is doing, but...
Finally, the monster is starting to succeed in this process and is beginning to transition to the more happy and heroic monster it is. If you listen carefully to our piece, you may be able to follow the story. Please enjoy.
The third group in this composition. The monster feels happy and heroic after everything he has been through. He feels accomplished and ready to be free. The chords and melodies we will be playing represent happiness and being heroic.
We have three motifs and chords for each motif. A motif is a short melody that expresses a certain idea or feeling when you listen.
We chose not to play chords the first time around because we wanted to introduce the happiness feeling, and we wanted the happiness feeling to progress. We wanted it to progress to show the fact that the monster's self-esteem was getting better.
In our first motif, the notes are also lower. This means that it will be more bold, and this will be evident in our piece.
For our second motif, we decided to brighten the mood, as the monster is getting happier. To do this, we use major chords that get higher and higher as the composition progresses.
For our third motif, we are using high notes, just like our last motif, except we are using pauses to give more interest and so the audience is more engaged.
We also chose not to have any chords the third time we play our third motif. Except the last couple of notes in our motif, people playing chords strum a C major. This ends off the composition on a happy feeling.
Listen now as we play our three motifs. Pay close attention to our three motifs and try to listen to the feelings and moods we've conveyed in our piece.
Now, all of our sections together. Hope you enjoy. Thank you.
us alone, cause we don't need your policies. We have no apologies for being firm, you ever wild. Oh my.
Fantastic job, grade six. What a great performance. Singing, dancing, acting, playing music, composing music, writing script. It's been a great year, and that was a great culmination of all the things that you've been doing in your class. I knew you were scary monsters inside when I first met you, and now I know. But all of you unique in your own little monster, which I love. So thank you very much, and thank you to our teaching team, Ms. Yakuchuk, Ms. Bernstein. Give a hand to our music teachers at the back. Give them a hand. And the house, Scott, Mr. Zechner in the house. Oh, sorry, the masks were made by Miss Reed, is that what you said? With Miss Reed. For their art, they did those. So what a great show and great culmination of what you've done. I hope you all enjoyed seeing your kids on stage and acting and doing all the things that they've done. Thank you very much for coming. Nice to see so many of you here to enjoy, and congratulations to all of you. Well done. Thank you very much.